Today I baked a Lego NXT robot. This is my first time baking NXT for a YouTube video. And only made 3 reels, I think. I don't know. First take 2 pins. And this very long beam. Put it on. There are those 2. You take another one. Sorry, this pin is actually broken.
Okay, he made a replica of that.
Take 1. So you also have to program this. I already saved the program, so I won't show it. But I did save it to show what it does. That look. That side. There you go. That. Let's take the folder. Put this piece there. And you put an axle there. And then put a wheel. Now I'm not going to put a stopper there because actually I got the touch sensor. Then I put this one and a half stopper, 1.5 length, 1.5 width. Yeah, 1.5 height stopper. And then 2 normal sized ones, and then again another half. Stopper on top, and then put this large here. So I just built this. So instead of pressing on the small point, I can just have a giant one like this, and I can just have it. Then repeat the same thing with the motor. Put that piece there. Another one here. Then put the connectors on the back of the motors. On. And then for the cable. Put the longest cable. Connect that to the touch sensor. So I can actually fold the touch sensor and also stand up. But, and I'll still be able to press it even though I will be standing. And then of course the 2 motor wires. Except this is a weird thing. I don't know why this happens. But if I plug in a motor into a motor and spin this one, the motor spins. If I unplug this motor, it won't spin together. And this time I'll just, instead I'll just plug that in. And plug this one in with the shortest cable. There you go, and you're done. Just going to give it a quick overview. Files, NXT files, Nivin 53790. So this is a NXT robot I made. So when I turn it on, it'll go forward. When I click the touch sensor, it'll go backwards. Then if I click it again, it'll go forward. This is an action.
There will be many more NXT models with more sensors.
That's it, bye.